What's up, guys? It's you, and welcome back to another episode of Pokemon Showdown Live. This is episode number 52 on the channel, and if I do sound a little bit more mellow in this episode, it's because it is a little bit later at night, and I'm going to Chicago tomorrow. I've had 7 basketball games this week, so, and, you know, I just kind of felt like recording. I've been bogged down with homework all week. Anyway, we're playing RU. I'm using this cool team my boy Wonder Bread passed me. Basically, it's just hard-hitting, fast-hyper offense with Mega Pidgeot, Hazard Stack, Omastar, Life Orb, Dragalge to beat Stall. This thing, which is cool, Normal Gym, Fake Out, Hitmonlee, Specs Meloetta, and Rock Polish Rhyperior. So, looking at this guy's team, it gets beat pretty bad by Rock Polish Rhyperior if I can't weaken these two things a little bit and weaken that. Do I have Mega Horn? I don't have Mega Horn. I have Dual Step. Okay. Different team. I'm gonna go and lead with Omastar right here just because it is my best lead, and he ends up leading Hitmonlee, which is fine. Hopefully he doesn't just fake out turn one and get like a normal. Oh, are you serious? Isn't that convenient? What is Wonderbread running this? Okay. I think Dragalge takes a hit. But I'm going to stay in and stealth rock because I don't want to risk losing anything else, I guess. Anyway, so I'm just going to go straight in into Dragalge and fire off a Draco because I want to see what his initial switch in is to this. So he just goes for the knockoff, gets rid of my life orb. That sucks, but he is dead. And Hitmonlee is actually a pretty big threat to offense and RU. Just because of how strong it is. He ends up going out into Jolteon, though, which isn't really a huge problem because I have a Meloetta. If he wants to go out into this and trap me, good play on his part, but he ends up just going for the HP Ice, and I'm going to go for the U-turn right here because I can maneuver my way around this Escavalier and go straight back out into Dragalge, I think. I believe that. No, I have a Pidgeot. Pidgeot is a very cool Pokemon, which hasn't actually gotten a lot of exposure on my channel so far, which is one reason I kind of wanted to use his team. But anyway, I'm going straight away for the Heat Wave because it hits most of his team neutrally. And that Escavalier is dead, and Mega Pidgeot is also very, very powerful. No Guard is a bigger buff than I think we were all expecting it to be. Not to say that people weren't expecting it to be good, but people weren't exactly expecting it to be the best ability. But anyway, I'm going right out into Meloetta right here because I do think it is my best switch. And he ends up just going for the Volt Switch. That did 25%. He'll probably just go into the Drapion, this one, to click Pursuit right here, which is kind of annoying because I don't outspeed him. But I'm just going to make a hard switch out right here to Rhyperior just in case he doesn't have Pursuit, which, you know, it's entirely possible he doesn't have Pursuit, but he ends up just going for the Night Slash, so he's this set. I will outspeed his entire team after a Rock Polish, so I'm just going to go and click that. Hopefully he goes out in a Pidgeot to dodge an Earthquake, and he ends up going on Reuniclus. That's fine with me, because now I'm fast, and I can just click Earthquake versus you, because it is 100% accurate, and will hit you for pretty good damage, considering I'm adamant, and I have 416 attack. That did 62%, that's nice. He goes for the Confuse Ray, but I have my Lumberry, so that's what you get for running Confuse Ray Reuniclus. I'm not super high on the RU ladder, if I'm being completely honest. I'm like 1263, that's not that high at all. But I kind of like pushing up into the top 500 in Showdown Live. So like we did that last week. We're going to try to do it this week. Let's actually check where the RU ladder is while we're waiting for this guy to make a move. And you say loading, and I say hurry up, friend. 1332? I think we can do that. But we end up just knocking out this Reuniclus right here. And he goes into Jolteon, which may outspeed me, actually. It probably will. We'll see if Rhyperior can tank one, because I have saw. Wow. Rhyperior, you are actually a trooper. And I feel like Rhyperior is actually going to be very, very valuable this week. And it is actually a very cool Pokemon, just because it has a very unique skill set aside from all other Pokemon that can kind of set it apart. But I think we have this game in the bag. As long as I don't miss the... Wait, he's gonna Mega Evolve. No Guard means we both have No Guard, and I can't miss Stone Edge. How about that? So his Pidgeot will go down right there. So that's a good game. And how long have we been going for? We've only been going for 5 minutes. We could grab another one. That's pretty nice. I get to do editing on the plane tomorrow. I've never done that before. Hopefully, none of my, like, friends that I'm traveling with realize that I'm, like, editing videos for the internet, because that would be kind of weird. None of my in-real-life friends know that I do YouTube, which I guess is kind of weird, but it's kind of a cool thing to talk about, because, like, I guess I do kind of lead a second life on the internet where I talk about my real life, but, like, I don't have, like, I do have a new name. I have a new alias. It's not, like, a new name, but you feel? either way, it's taken a while to find a battle, so we will be right back. Alright, back. Anyway, so this guy's using a Kingler, which is pretty cool, because it can run agility. But, unless this is running Defog, I don't think... No, that has spin. I'm having to relearn this tier. I'm going to go ahead and lead Omastar, though, because I can just get my Stealth Rocks up at pretty much any cost, as he leads with this, and I'm just gonna fire off an ice beam, if I'm being completely honest, because he's more than likely just gonna get up his rocks right here. That did no damage. That is a soul vest. That's a soul vest. That has to be, yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna mega evolve right here and go straight away for the U-turn. We'll see what move he goes for. But why use a soul vest Dredagon? It is like the worst type. Yo, that's just spadef. Help me. So he's going for rocks. He goes for glare. That's helpful, considering I'm an Omastar. I'm just going to try to get my stealth rocks up. We'll see how this goes. He ends up just going for a dragon tail, phasing me out. So I'm just going to click hurricane right here. I do think it will knock him out from this range, because I am significantly stronger than Omastar, and this does get stabbed. As he goes out in a spear team, which is not a counter. That is a 2-hit KO. That is definitely not a counter. He can't even, like, shadow sneak me or anything, for I am part of the normal type. I wish Mega Pidgeot got, like, hyper voice, because that would be pretty cool to run dual stab, although normal stab doesn't really help it a whole lot. It's nice to just have general neutral coverage versus things. So he goes out into his own Pidgeot. I think right here I'm clicking Hurricane, to be honest. Actually, this thing's nice to have. It's really nice to have, because it outpaces Durant, too. So I'm going straight out into Rhyperior, because Rhyperior actually does a number to his team, and Rock Polish Rhyperior is a pretty underrated threat, just because it's so bulky. You guys saw in the last battle how well it ate up that HP ice from... Don't confuse me. Okay, Rhyperior, I just was bragging about your bulk. You can't just let me down like that. You can't take 46% on a resisted hit. And he reveals the HP grass. You're a lord. I think right here I'm just going to go straight out into Hitmonlee and do as much damage as I can right here. I could also go out into like something like Meloetta, but not sure that's my best option. Actually, is it though? I'm going to go out to Meloetta right here. Hopefully I don't get donked by this hurricane. Hopefully I don't have confusion be a thing that happens to me, but Specs Meloetta is pretty cool, and is actually one of my favorite mons to use in RU, just because it hits so hard, and Hyper Voice with the new animation coming through, it just hits so hard, and it feels so weak without Specs that I just generally run it all the time. I guess the Pokemon I would compare it to the most is Keldeo. Actually, do they have the same special attack? Did I just make a good comparison? They have almost the same special attack. Look at that. Meloetta is more bulky, Keldeo is faster. So the Keldeo actually only has 580 base stat total. That's weird. Meloetta, underrated threat. He also lost his Meloetta counter in Spiritomb, which is a little bit disappointing for him, but you know, I'm not too broken up about it. He may actually he goes out in Kingler. That's fine, unless he's like Scarf. Reveal Sheer Force Scald. That just died. So I think Hitmonlee actually just wins at this point, because this will actually knock me out if it manages to hit through Hustle. He ends up going for Home Claws. Do not set up on threats. That did 79%. If you're Life Orb, you're dead. Although I highly doubt his Life Orb. No, never mind, he's Life Orb. I'm just going to go straight out into Mega Pidgeot right here, because Mega Pidgeot can take whatever he sends out on. Never mind, he just ends up forfeiting. So we're up into the 1300s. That's pretty cool. And that is going to be it for today's episode. So if you guys did enjoy, please make sure to leave a like, as it really does help show support for the stuff that I'm doing here on the channel. Also, make sure to answer today's comment question of the video, which is Rhyperior actually put in a lot of work this episode. Have you guys ever tried using a Rhyperior or any of its evolutionary line? I know Rhydon is viable in NU, which is pretty cool. Double Dance is pretty rad. Either way, with that, I urge you guys to subscribe if you guys are enjoying the constant content. And with that, I'll catch you on the flip-flop.